This shaft at Annacis Island Wastewater Treatment Plant leads to a massive and challenging Metro Vancouver construction project, one that can only be seen by going 40 meters below the surface. This is the entrance to the new tunnel, which will be nearly a kilometer long when completed. The tunnel is partially done at this point, and it will run from the treatment plant and underneath the bottom of the Fraser River.
This tunnel will convey treated wastewater out to the Fraser River to provide additional capacity for the Annacis Island Wastewater Treatment Plant.
The new tunnel will replace an existing one that runs from the plant to the river and is becoming too small to serve the region's growing population.
The population is expected to grow. That's why the plant is being expanded in a number of stages over the next few years to be able to handle that flow that's going to be coming down the pipe, you could say.
This is the front section of the tunnel boring machine, which is about 63 meters in length. It chews through the earth to create the tunnel. The tunnel boring machine is similar to this one, seen here in cross-section. It both digs the tunnel and installs the concrete lining. Each ring of the tunnel lining is painstakingly built. The concrete ring segments are conveyed to the front of the tunnel boring machine. Then they are slowly lifted and fitted into place to form the finished ring. Each ring takes 30 to 60 minutes to build, and the machine advances an average of 10 meters a day. As the machine moves forward, the excavated earth falls into the front of the machine, rocks sink to the bottom, and smaller particles get mixed into a suspension fluid, creating a slurry. The slurry is then pumped to the surface, where the dirt is separated from the fluid. Then, the slurry is reused to help conserve water. The tunnel boring machine's final destination is below this barge, in the middle of the Fraser River. The new tunnel will have to precisely join up beneath the riverbed to this massive structure called a river riser, which has now been embedded into the bottom of the Fraser. It is a unique engineering challenge, one that Metro Vancouver has planned for years.